Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, hello and welcome to Fraser Park Sportsville, Lower Hutt, New Zealand. You're watching the 2019 Hutt Valley Softball Association presentation for the Softball New Zealand Under-23 Championships. I'm Stacey Taylor here for Hutt Valley Softball Broadcasting Crew on the final day for the Under-23 Men's Softball New Zealand Grand Final. The visiting team in the first base dugout in green and gold will be Hutt Valley. In the third base dugout and taking the field first in the black and gold will be Wellington. The starting lineups for today. Number 3, playing right field, Jared Gillard. Number 4, catching for Hutt Valley today, Jay Johnston. Number 27 and playing second base, Liam Udy-Johns. Number 12 and on the mound, Adam Woon. Number 22 in the hot corner, Cole Keating. Number 11 holding up first base, Brad Carson. Number 13 playing center field, Sage Shaw Tate. Number 28 at shortstop, Kiriyama Watanitohou. Rounding out the hitting lineup, number 15, Taina Tianui, playing left field. In the DP position, number 34, Braden Hampton. Your substitutes for the Hutt Valley team today, Jonathan Little, Caleb Taylor, and Rehana Walker-Logan. The coaching staff for Hutt Valley, head coach Craig Wallace, assistant coach Scott Cartwright, and manager Scott Easthope. For Wellington, he'll be taking the field today. Number 73, playing second base, Dante Matakatia. Number 77 at third base, Xavier Herrick. Number 95 taking the mound, Riley Markia. Number 44 and playing shortstop, Zach Boyd. Number 72 in left field, Alex London. Number 52 playing first base, Jaden Stratford. Number 78 in centre field, Damon Cressy. Doing the catching today, number 84, Callum Carson. Rounding out the hitting order today and playing in right field, number 92, Andre Hart. The designated player for today, number 83, Josh Merritt. The Wellington reserves today, number 69, Dwight Stoddard. Number 70, Norpeta Stockford. Number 76, Eru Drage. And number 50, Josh Jacobs. Followed out by head coach Johnny Stratford, assistant coach Warren Stoddard, and manager Michelle Stratford. Round of applause for both teams, ladies and gentlemen. Moving on to the umpiring duties for today. At home plate, we have Dave Beaumont. First base, Ben Horn. Second base, Ben Dyson. And our third base umpire for today, Robbie Sangrove. Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for players and umpires. The official scorer for today will be Margaret Marsh. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem. Now let's play ball.
Well, hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Fraser Park, Sportsville, Lower Hutt, New Zealand. You're obviously watching the 2019 Hutt Valley Softball presentation of the Under-23 Softball New Zealand Championship. The men's final is about to get underway, the penultimate game here on Championship Sunday. I'm Jason Gerbes, a.k.a. Chopper, on day four here for game number 48. Yes, you got it. It's the men's grand final, and with me in the booth is Damien Collins extraordinaire. Damien, welcome to the booth.
Thank you for having me, Chopper. Awesome to be here for this grand final today between Wellington and Hutt Valley. Going to be a great game here on Diamond One. As you said, game 48. We've had a few, and this is the last one.
Well, it sure is, Damien. What do you think a matchup between these two heavyweights in the same region, the 04 Wellington and Hutt Valley, will bring?
We always have a good tussle between that Wellington and Hutt Valley side. They played at the last game of game one, of course, Wellington winning that one 13-1. But of course, first day was Hutt Valley's first day together in general. So a couple of days later, there'll be the moulding at the right time.
Well, moulding at the right time. This is day four, game 48, as we said. The last one on the schedule of 4 days of competition here in the Lower Hutt, hosted by the Hutt Valley Softball Association. They've done a great job here this weekend. Let's look at your fielding lineup now for Wellington. They have Alex London at left, Damon Greasy at centre, Andre Hart, he is at right. Xavier Herrick will be in the hot corner, Zach Boyd at shortstop, Dante Matakatia will be the second baseman, Jaden Stratford at one, Callum Carson for the switch on the lineup here card. The DP will come into pitch, Riley Markia. Batting lineup for Hutt Valley, Jared Gillard will lead off. Just about ready for the first pitch here of the grand final. And drop ball just over the top. Batting lineup for the rest of the batting lineup for the Hutt Valley team will be Jay Johnson, the catcher, Liam Udi Johns, Adam Woon, Keating, Carson, Shaw Tate. Outside looking at that one, that'll be two balls to Gillard. Kiriyama Watene Taho, the shortstop, will bat in the eighth spot, and the youngster, Taina Teaonui, will round out the batting order for Hutt Valley here as we get underway in the top of the first innings. Loud swing at that one from Gillard, fouls it back over the screen. Interesting to note, Gillard plays with a bit of passion as he eyes back down to the moustache-looking young Riley Markia on the hill.
Youngest of the Markia clan has been top pitcher at this tournament with 110 batters face, 24.2 innings pitched, 5 earned runs with earned run average of just 1.42.
Just 1.42, that is as measly as it gets. And Riley Markia having himself an exceptional Under-23 tournament on the pitcher's mound. Gillard just a stone in the glove, he'll take that out. Like a good leadoff hitter here, taking his time.
Setting the pace early, just taking his time, getting into the box. He's already playing the mind games.
Well, a game within the game, and that game is won by Gillard as he'll watch the fifth delivery. That'll be a ball and go down to the first base with a walk.
Well, Gillard doing what he has to do as that first leadoff batter getting on base. Mark here probably hasn't walked many players during this tournament.
No, he goes straight, tends to go straight at them, does Mark here. That's his MO.
Fouled away by Jay Johnson, one of the top batters of this tournament. Hitting a big bomb in that semi-final against Auckland. one of the reasons why, well, he was our player of the match.
He sure was in the morning matchup against Auckland. Jay Johnson, first innings, blasts one. And he blasts one the other way. This time goes Jay Johnson. He'll go to one with these, and pulling up the stop sign at two will be Gillard. And bang, bang, thank you, ma'am. Walk and a hit. They're underway, Hutt Valley.
How good is that hit, though? Hitting it directly in the middle of shorts from first base and second. Exactly what that second batter wants to do, move that front runner.
Well, while we've got you, we just want to thank you for your patience with the streaming. We've had this morning some issues with the internet supply. This one up the middle. It's a flat hit for Moody Johns. It'll come the first run of the final, and Gillard smashes his hand against his teammates in celebration. Hutt Valley up early in this one. No outs.
Yeah, hips straight back to Mark here, who's usually a top fielder, letting that one just go past him, out of reach for the second baseman. And look at that. They've got an RBI and a base hit. So, well, Hutt Valley with two runners on. Great start to this competition.
Well, with the pace of Gillard from second base and the ball not that as hard hit going to Greasy at centre, didn't bother about throwing it home on that play. This one comes low. First delivery to the designated player for Hutt Valley. That is Adam Wu.
You could almost have him as designated utility. He's been batting and pitching very well this tournament.
That he has, Adam Moon, putting his hand up for MVP status as well, to be fair. This one pops up and goes foul.
That wind picking up here, grand final. the 10 in front of us almost taking the trailer with it. Hopefully not a factor for these two quality teams here in the grand final today.
Well, two quality teams indeed. Wellington and Hutt Valley been marching through this tournament. Hutt Valley, a couple of blips on the map. Running bunt, goes foul. We have a look at Hutt Valley as they went through the round robin, and they were a 3-2 record. Finished in fourth place after the round robin. They dropped the game to Canterbury 2-9, and they dropped the game to Wellington, listen to this, 13-1. Wellington gave them a spanking in the round robin, fourth place, but they've managed to come through the playoff system, have Hutt Valley, and get all the way to the penultimate game here, the grand final. There goes Woon. And Jay Johnson will go station to station as that ball hit in the air, a liner, but almost could have been snagged by a fielder, so he had to hold just so he wouldn't get doubled up. Otherwise, he would have been able to come home in that play. That'll bring out time called by the head coach for Hutt Valley, and that is Craig Wallace to have a chat with his men.
Well, Hutt Valley coming out here with guns blazing. Four batters up, four batters on, and they've loaded the bases with an Adam Wern hit straight up the centre.
Well, Adam Wern has been exceptionally in the batter's box this week, and even equal to that on the pitching circle. And he is listed as the DP. We might see them make the same move that Wellington has made here and see him come in fact to pitch to start this game. I'd be surprised if that's not the move that they make. And it's just a matter of time. Adam Woon stars on the mound again here. Two great pitchers. Markia Woon, one of them would be victorious here and be reigned the champion for 2019 in the under-23 level.
That's right, Chopper. As I mentioned, Riley Mark here on top of the stats, but just behind him, Adam Woon with 118 batters faced, 30 innings pitched, 7 earned runs with an earned run average of 1.63 before today's. But of course, he pitched that beautiful final against Auckland.
Well, as they always say, pitching will get you to the last game on Sunday, and the two top pitchers in attendance are here in this final for this one. Cole Keating steps in now, the third baseman. He'll foul off the first pitch he sees. Riley Markia, the MO on him, an electrifying low lifter that seems to just pop as it gets close to the batter. But we've noticed, Damien, over the last 2 days of play, he's brought in a punishing drop ball that seems to be electric. Keating, Texas League in the centre. In comes one, in comes two, and the tag at three. He is safe. Safe at third base. Woon goes to three on it. That's an aggressive base running, but Keating Texas Liga drives in two, and just like that, baby, oh baby, Hutt Valley off to the best start possible.
Keating just finding the gap just on the outside, up the middle. That's another hit up the middle. Keating will sit pretty on one. They've got runners on the corners, and they've scored another two to take their lead to 3-0.
Well, it couldn't be any better for the men in green and white from Hutt Valley. That one comes through the zone on Brad Carson, the next batter. No outs recorded yet in the top of the first innings. Four hits given up, three runners crossing the plate.
Brad Carson hitting that. Keating still second with pitch just coming off. Carson's glove at catch.
The live wire is Cole Keating visiting from Canada, I understand, and playing for Hutt Valley here. Don't normally see that at under-23 level, but congratulations on him for getting an inside look to representative softball within the provinces of New Zealand. Brad Carson looks in again. This one comes down and clips the edge of the zone. That'll move the count now, 1-2, of course. We'll have the scoreboard up for you momentarily.
That's right, Brad Carson in the box now. He's been batting well this tournament. Of course, first baseman from the Dodgers Club here on Fraser Park, so it's a little bit of a home ground for him.
Well, he swings through that drop ball on the inside edge from Riley Markey to record the first out of the innings, and his team needs him right now because Hutt Valley are look menacing to get started in this one. One out and obviously two runners in scoring position after three have crossed the plate already.
Yeah, with just one out, Craig Wallace having a little talk to Sage Shaw-Tate, who's up to bat.
Sage Shaw-Tate with a swing to change the score right there, swings through that low lifter.
Sage Shaw-Tate, another Dodgers player right here from Fraser Park, playing on his home ground.
This one just missing on the outside edge. Interesting shaping up for a bunt. Hot corners, charging on it. And with the head coach, Craig Wallace down at third, Scott Cartwright assisting at one. That will try and use every tool in the toolbox here to push over another run. Rise ball up top.
Some smart batting from Hutt Valley today. Not only have they been finding the holes with the bat through the middle, they've been laying it down with the running bunt and slap and getting on base.
Foul back.
Shaw-Tate, very talented young man. Softball, touch, rugby, even baseball.
But he's got a D on the front of his helmet. Could be Dodgers or could be danger time for Wellington. Sage Shaw-Tate early in this one with a real big opportunity. And he can't get that one on the outside edge as it comes through the zone. And I'm pretty sure that's the count. And he'll be set down, yes indeed. That second strikeout in a row, this time caught looking, was Shaw-Tate. So Markey out looking to settle things down. But it doesn't get any easier because the shortstop for Hutt Valley is the power hitting Kiriama Watenitaho.
Kiriama Watenitaho from the Dodgers Club, another one playing on his home field. You wouldn't think that they get a top of Markey in this first inning.
Full swing from Watenitaho. Fouls back. Callum Carson behind the dish. He's been the stalwart for Wellington through this event. Man of steel, almost caught every single innings.
Must have good knees if he's done that.
Good knees indeed. Well, he's from Hawke's Bay originally, as Callum Carson. Plays his club ball for the Punika Kalburni, or PK as everyone probably knows it, here in Wellington. That team managed by none other than our broadcasting crew members, Chanel Masters and Dallas Parker. It's great to have them in the crew this week. Those two ladies have been outstanding in their effort to help bring this broadcast to you all around New Zealand. And across the globe these days, it's amazing the viewership we get.
Yeah, you know yourself, Choppy. We can't do our game without the help of some extraordinary individuals, and those two ladies are two of them.
We're back to the action here. And low lifter gets him on the inside edge. And Hutt Valley start with a walk. Back to back to back to back singles. And that puts over three runs. But then Riley Markia says, not on my watch. Sits down three guys on strikes in a row. What do you think about the start to the game?
What a comeback. I mean, you've got three runners batted in. You've got two runners on base. And Riley Markia stands up with a K and two KCs to finish off Hutt Valley in this first innings. That just shows the quality of the player that Markia is, to be on the mound and not let it slip when the going gets cut.
Well, that's what champions do. Hutt Valley, Wellington. It'll be a beauty. Don't change the dial. Don't click your button because it's all coming to you. Bottom one coming up. Well, welcome back to Fraser Ballpark, ladies and gentlemen. In the beautiful region of Lower Hutt, that's the bottom of the North Island, but the middle of New Zealand, or Aotearoa, also known as. There are three official languages to New Zealand. Sign language is one. I should have thrown that as a question, really. English is another, and one of my favourites, Te Reo, the native language of the Māori people, is the third. Aotearoa is the Māori word for New Zealand, and that's where we are. Playing the Under-23 National Championship for Softball New Zealand, hosted by the Hutt Valley Softball Association. I'm Jason Gerbes, a.k.a. Chopper, bringing you this broadcast for the 04 commentary crew. Damien Collins in attendance with me in the booth. Stacey Taylor calling the ground announcing on this one. The fielding lineup for Hutt Valley, let's give that to you. We'll see Tao Nui at left, Shaw Tate at centre, Gillard at right. Keating in the hot corner, Watene to hose the shortstop, Uri Johns at two, Carson at one, Johnson behind the dish, and as we thought, they've made the move and brought in Adam Woon to start this ball game on the hill. Dante Matakatea will lead off. And he goes at the first pitch, and boy, oh boy, that gave me a sore back watching him swing.
Yes, he put everything he had into it. Dante Matakatea has been outstanding this. He's in the top batters after 3 days. He at-bats 19, hits 7 with a batting average of 3.68.
Well, that's an impressive click indeed for the leadoff hitter from the Wellington team, as that one will level the count 1-1. Xavier Herrick will hit 2. Riley Markia, the pitcher, will hit 3. Zach Boyd, the shortstop, small in stature but big in punch. He's in the cleanup spot. Alex London hits 5. Stratford, Greasy, Carson, and Andre Hart rounds out the batting lineup for Wellington. Ball up top, but I got to tell you, the look on the face of Adam Woon and the velocity of that drop ball, he is here to play.
He's definitely here to play, Chop. He had an outstanding game against Auckland earlier on in the day, winning that one 13-3. Who would have thought that?
This one up top. And both leadoff batters being patient. We saw that from Gillard. Earned himself a walk to start off on 5 pitches. Can Markia do the same thing? No! Wow. I tell you what, for a second baseman, he's not a big man, Matakatea. Boy, he swings it heavy.
Well, he's been around the game a few years playing senior level now. Chop, he's we've seen him a few times at the PK Classic, and if he's still under 23, still got a long way to go in this game.
He sure does. And hard hit ball from Matakatea. That'll go to centre field. He'll around first, put on the anchors, come back, and says to his team, come on, let's go.
Matakatea with all the power, throwing, sending it straight up the middle, and then a bit of a chest hit there, and tells his team, yep, I've done my go, I've led off, now it's your turn, boys.
Well, whose turn is it? Third baseman, number 77, Xavier Herrick. He'll come in the bat next for the Wellingtonians.
Xavier Herrick also on the top batters of this tournament in 11, 22 at bats, 8 hits with a batting average of 3.64.
Oh, there you go. Pitchers at the top of the stats. The hitters in both teams at the top of the stats. You add that all together, what does that mean? We're in for a hell of a ball game. That one comes through.
Xavier Herrick, another one out of the PK club. Right-handed batter, tall of stature, uses all the box.
He's a big lad, as Xavier Herrick. I've seen him coming through the age groups, originally from Hooks Bay, to be fair. That one comes through, plenty of pace. So they will know each other very, very well, will Adam Woon, as he's originally from Hooks Bay as well.
Yes, you always love a tussle with a mate of yours, definitely from the region, always good.
Bunt goes down, that's a sacrifice, and they'll get the job done, does Herrick. Moves over Matakatia into scoring position.
Cole Keaton with the gas coming in, scooping it up like he's done, and firing it to first where Carson makes a play, outstanding and smooth play there from Hutt Valley to get the first out.
Well, they've set it up. They've set up the stage here for the, my mind, the MVP for the Wellington team, and that is Riley Markia, the starting pitcher, to come up to bat.
Well, they've walked him, Chop. The intentional walk has Riley Markia. Not only has he been the top pitcher of this tournament up until the start of the day, he was second in RBIs with 11. Most home runs were 5, and his batting average, 21 at bat, 9 hits, and for a batting average of 4.29, 9 hits and 5 home runs. Wow, dangerous.
Well, remember, he's the starting pitcher was Markia, and they won't have a bar of him. Obviously, they've given him the intentional pass. He's gone down to first base as Zach Boyd punches that one to third to the third baseman, and they'll get the lead runner going in there. So two down now. Markia just too dangerous, gets the intentional pass. So with two outs, they'll move to Alex London, the left fielder.
Impressed with Cole Keaton picking that up and knowing exactly what to do by holding up, getting the lead runner, tagging out. Almost threw it to first, but thought against it. Good out by Keaton.
This one comes through the zone for a strike.
Alex London from the Miramar.
Ground ball with a collision, and that's going to be trouble. Coming home, he goes to the tag, and Johnson, he tries to go over the top, does Boyd. But boy, oh boy, there's a collision up the middle. That one goes up the middle. Second baseman, Udi Johns, colliding into Watene Taho, the shortstop. Watene Taho gets flattened in the collision. He gets up grimacing, but he is walking back to the dugout as Watene Taho. But at the same time, during all of that collision and calamity, a runner comes in for the Wellington team, and they'll pick up a run there. Zach Boyd tries to score as well, tagged out on a good heads-up play by the catcher Carson, receiving the ball from the outfield. So action, action, action. Don't change the channel, don't blink an eye. You'll miss it if you do. Top two coming up. Wellington, Hutt Valley, still in the lead. Well, welcome back to Fraser Ballpark. She's all been happening here. And just noticing that the Wellington team just so pumped up out there and ready to rock and roll. Exciting game we've got going on here between Hutt Valley and Wellington. Four runs scored off six hits so far, and it's had a bit of everything already in such a short period. Great to see these teams able to go each other hammer and tong here, Damien. What do you think about the start?
Well, those balls up the middle, they're hitting the ball and they're getting the gaps. You know, it's not as if fielders are making the errors. The batters are finding the holes. And what can you do? Great start from both teams.
Well, it is a great start indeed. And they'll look to try and add to it. Will Hutt Valley. We saw Marquez settle down, striking out three batters in a row to stop the bleeding there in the top of the first innings. And Hutt Valley will send up the youngster in the nine hole, and that is Taina Taunui.
Twice he's run up, squared up for the bunt, thought against it. Another strike against him.
That one comes through the zone. 1-1 now the count on him. And missing on the running bunt attempt. Interesting to look at Stratford and Matakatia fielding a little shallow on the lefty slapper, Taunui. Well, as we look around the ballpark, it is packed, bumper to bumper, all the way around first and third base lines, but also around the home run fence line and up on the hill out there. Boy, oh boy, how many of you think's in attendance today, Damien?
Oh, there'd be four figures, I reckon.
Easily. Fantastic result for the Hutt Valley Softball Association. The Under-23 National Championship, the penultimate game here, the grand final.
Yeah, Fraser Park, great venue for softball. This ballpark being transformed over the last few years. Of course, we've got the artificial turf on Diamond 1, which slows down the ball a bit, doesn't give it that big bounce that some of the skin diamonds have.
Here comes a payoff pitch, and it's through the zone. Markia with a fourth strikeout in a row sets down Taunui to start off the top of the second.
As I said, it just shows the class of Markia to go and lose those three runs in the first innings and then come back and strike out the next four batters.
Well, we'll go back to the top of the shop now, and that'll be Jared Gillard, of course. Pulls that one through, does Mark here. Well, if there was ever any need for any motivation, it sure as heck isn't needed here today. Both of these teams, Damien, look ready for battle.
They do indeed, Chop. And they probably know each other very well, being our neighbours, you know. And always a great tussle between Wellington and Hutt Valley. And with this, all the support that they've got here, yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Well, you say our neighbours there, Damien, as if you're out there playing the game. Which team are you going for?
Well, not at all. I'm here completely as impartial commentary with yourself, Chopper. I'm not wearing a Hutt Valley hat, but I probably could be.
Well, we can see the scoreboard is up and running now. Finally got that going for you. Thank you for your patience. Hopefully we'll have an uninterrupted stream. We have cut down the cameras just so we can get it nice and smooth out to you. I hope you're okay with that. We'll walk on. We had seven cameras in operation in the women's final. And I think one of the problems we had, just for some explanation for you, is that we're running off a 4G network. There is no Wi-Fi network here at Fraser Ballpark. And with so many people in attendance, everyone on social media these days, videoing and texting and Instagram and whatever else that tickles your fancy, I think that's just chewing into the data allowance of 4G network here available at Fraser Park. So we've made some changes. Hopefully that works for you. You're getting a better stream now, maybe not as many cameras, but as long as it's smooth, you've got the smooth tone of Damien Collins to bring this puppy home.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Jared Gillard working hard here. 2-2 the count on him at the moment.
Gillard scored in the first at bat, that first innings.
Goes the other way, does Gillard. He is up for it. Draws a walk, his first at bat, drives this one with the drop ball on the outside to right field for a single here in the second.
Beautiful hit, just dropping over Stratford. So he couldn't get to it. The right fielder Hart couldn't get to it. Perfect placement from that bat.
Perfect placement indeed. Well, one of the men of the moment this week, the catcher from Hutt Valley, has been exceptional. Off and running is Gillard, and I think he may have a little bit of a head start. Damon, did you catch that?
No, I just saw him go, but the umpire caught it, and he has called him out.
He isn't
going early.
Some of us need a little head start. He doesn't, he's quick, but I think our video switcher caught it all the action. So there you go, Chanel Masters, thank you. Gillard is thrown out by the first base umpire in this one, Ben Horn, for leaving early. Well, back to the action, Jay Johnson. The pitch wouldn't have counted, of course. Jay Johnson just asking, will that be two balls or one? The pitch does not count on on leaving early, because the infraction happens before the delivery. That's the reason you're out, for leaving the base before the delivery's made.
Yeah, we saw it in that women's final as well, just when Auckland needed them.
So Jay Johnson was asking if it was two balls before. Well, it is now. He's got himself a hitter's count. Jay Johnson. I've seen some good sell jobs. This one just misses his thigh. And he asked the umpire, did that touch my thigh?
Classic catcher, always chancing it. You know, the quick freeze frame when the ball's a bit outside and that just taps his leg. Oh, yeah, hit me on the inside.
The only thing could be better if the umpire called that a strike. Three balls to count now. Ooh. Actually, might check the count. The high school's got a strike. This one's low. Oh, well, he did indeed. He said, did that hit me? And the umpire said, no, it was a strike. That is gold. Thank you very much for the entertainment, Jay Johnson. 3-1 the count on him now, though. This one off the handle, taken by Herrick. He'll spin, throw, and take the last out. 1-2-3, they come up in the top of the second innings. Boy, that's far different from the top of the first. Hutt Valley was so menacing there to get this one rolling. Bottom two coming up. 3-1, Hutt Valley lead. Welcome back to Fraser Ballpark here. You are watching the Under-23 National Championship. It is the men's turn. Wellington taking on Hutt Valley. Actually, I had this question the other day, mate. I'm trying to find the answer. If you know the answer to this, what happens when you take a first and a last name, use the first initial of the first name, put it with the last name, there's a phrase for it. What is it called? I just said Wellington for Hutt Valley Wellington. So for some reason, I have it on my mind. I need to know what the version is called so I can have an excuse for it. Anyway, that one sails through for a ball. And Johnny Stratford, the first baseman, gets us started here in the second innings. Hard ball hit the other way, but Udi Johns will corral it and throw him out going to one.
Not much has got past Udi Johns this tournament. Any ball realistically that has been hit to second base, he's scooped up. And that combination between Udi Johns and Carson's been a good one.
It is indeed. And Udi Johns is a big man. Just ask Waitene Taho. He's probably still stinging from the impact in the first innings. That one just high on Damon Greasy, the centre fielder now for Wellington.
Damon from the Porirua Club. He's been playing well this tournament, hitting when he needs to.
Comes inside. Adam Woon started with a bit more pounce and attacking the strike zone in the first innings. This one, just choosing his poison. Overthrown, drop ball too high. And Greasy will be the beneficiary of three straight balls. Damon Greasy just tried a David Ortiz, started walking to first base during the delivery. You might have to get a little bit bigger to be Big Papi on that one. 3-1 the count. There's a cut from Greasy. Had other ideas staying in the pocket, but swings underneath the low lifter from Wu.
Gave everything to that one. Wanted to send it somewhere.
Well, that'll load it up, of course. Here comes the payoff pitch from Wu. And it's a check swing, one bounce to Udi Johns. Boy, oh boy, that kid makes it look simple.
Doesn't he just? Skips it. One huge lunge from that tall frame of his, scoops it up and pops it up to Carson. Again, that 4-3 combination.
Well, for some viewers that have just joined the tournament for the grand final, the infield here at Fraser Park is a little bit different to what we're normally used to, Damien. What is the type of material the infield's made of?
Well, it's made of artificial grass with a rubber base, so it's not a sand base like most. It's a rubber base. Basically, you've just shredded tyres.
Right, so it's an artificial grass. That's the big thing, especially. And so there is no skin diamond or crushed brick that you may be used to, especially in the Northern Hemisphere. And what's the reason behind that?
Well, a huge development here at Fraser Park over the last couple of years. We've got a new complex being built called Sportsville, which every team club that is affiliated with Fraser Park is coming in under one roof. So we've got Avalon Rugby, Hutt City, Dodgers, Hutt City Unite. We've got softball, squash, tennis, hockey, and football. We're all coming under one roof. So they've redeveloped, and this is what we get.
Wow, that's a lot of ball clubs coming into one facility. You say Avalon Rugby, is that the Wolves?
It is the Wolves.
The one and only?
The one and only.
The one and only Avalon Wolves. Well, congratulations to them for the facility and a great idea with a multi-sport complex. But really the answer I was looking for is trying to put you under the bus. I'm not saying it rains a lot here in Wellington or Hutt Valley. No, I am saying it rains a lot. And of course, with the artificial turf, they can get back on there and play without any issue with the weather. And saying that, Damien, the weather has been outstanding this week. Sure, a bit of breeze, but that's not unusual for this area, but not a drop of rain.
No, even the first day, we were a bit chilly with that wind, but no, it was dry, and it has been dry ever since. Only a bit of a breeze and a bit of cloud today.
Well, a bit of a breeze and a bit of a cloud, and it goes through the glove of Te Ao Nui and ricochets off the fence. Boy, he got lucky after that. Callum Carson got the middle of that line drive to left field, misplayed by the outfielder Te Ao Nui, went back to the fence. Remember, Te Ao Nui was coming forward on that play. Normally that would have been a triple, but it hits the fence, hits the metal post, and ricochets back real quick and limits Carson the second base.
Yeah, the routine kick, if the another metre forward, maybe Te Ao Nui would have got it. And, of course, the unlucky bounce off the back fence.
Well, AJ Hart, he doesn't need any favours. He's an exceptional hitter. Tebasone Junior Black Sox player. And they have ruled it an error on Te Ao Nui. He should have made the catch, and an error it is by the official scorer.
Speaking of Andre Hart, he is in the top batters of this tournament with the most 9 RBIs to his name.
Well, we'll be looking for his 10th RBI here. And with two outs, that RBI will be Damon Greasy, who comes out to run for the catcher, Carson.
Yeah, Damon Greasy with the wheels at second in scoring position for this Wellington side that's down 3-1.
Well, I told you that Hart needs no favours. Now sitting in a hitter's count, choked up just a little on the bat, and he swings through that drop ball.
Huge swing there.
We have a northerly here in attendance for the Championship Sunday. That means it is blowing and is gusting from home plate to centre. Get it up in the jet stream, a pop fly will go. Oh, Hart looking steady in the batter's box. Works another hitter's count, 3-1 now. Oh, just double check, so 3-1 or 2-2? Official scorer's got 2-2. And it was indeed, because that'll sit him down as he goes over the top of the drop ball, does Andre Hart. And Callum Carson laces one to left field. Lucky for the outfielder, Tiaunu, ricochets off the middle pole, comes back in quickly, otherwise he would have been on third. And doesn't matter, because Adam Woon says, not on my watch. AJ Hart goes down on strikes. That'll do the bottom of the second innings. We'll be back in the top three. 3-1.
Your team lose again, bro.
I've never seen a ball bounce like that before.
The weekend's for calls. Make yours at tab.co.nz.
Welcome back to Fraser Ballpark, and just chatting off air with my commentary colleague, Damien Collins. Damien, got to say, this week has been such a ball here, watching this age group, under-23s. We know the majority of these young men play premier softball in New Zealand. That's the adult elite level. But when you take out those elite men players out of the equation and allow them to play within their age group, it allows these new men to start to shine. We see Jay Johnson being one of the standout performers behind the dish. Doesn't get that opportunity when they're playing against some of those elite stars.
That's right, Chop. At the age group, you can't be older. And it's good to see a lot of these guys wear their provincial colours. A lot of these players been around the game. I didn't even know half of them were under 23, to be honest, the amount of tournaments that we've done and seen the names around.
Well, you're right. And we've seen a couple of decent beards this week.
Oh, have we what?
We've seen a couple of unusual hairstyles this week.
Lamb's tail.
Yes, the young Braveheart, Wilkins Jenkins, I think it is, from Southland, sporting the most special haircut this week. Anyway, back to the action here. Liam Udy-Johns will go first. Woon, and this is off the end of the bat, and he'll throw that underhand. Will mark here to first base to preserve the arm.
Udy-Johns, the second baseman, has been outstanding with the bat this tournament, but he sends it straight back to Markio, who makes no mistake about it, throwing it down to Stratford at one.
Well, we talk about the wind blustering. Well, right now, it has turned it up a notch, and it's not unusual for gale force winds to come into play in Wellington. And I tell you, it's not a gale force wind yet, but boy, oh boy, it's getting up.
Well, 21 years ago, we named our Super Rugby team the Hurricanes, and I'm wondering, we've never questioned it.
And Woon puts it up in the Hurricane, and the Hurricane takes it out of here. Adam Woon drives one the other way, and the Hurricane takes it out of the yard for a home run.
Adam Woon, huge smile as he crosses home plate. I wouldn't be surprised if he'd been in the MVP talks this tournament. Chop, he's been awesome on the mound, and that is not his first home run at bat.
Well, the young kid from Hawke's Bay, originally from the Saints Ball Club, now playing out of Hutt City United down here in the Hutt Valley. Boy, oh boy, making his presence felt in the grand final here this afternoon. Cole Keating, the third baseman, steps in with a lead of 3 runs now for Hutt Valley.
Cole Keating, another player that has impressed me this tournament, the player from Canada.
takes that one outside to get started. Markia Pearson to Carson, leans back. Rock and fire with a lifter. Now, of course, with that jet stream going, or hurricane going out of here, that does mean there's more movement on the pitch. So Markia gets that advantage, slows the pitch down a little, but allows it to pop and drop a little bit more.
Well, Markia's pitches already have a hell of a spin on it. So if you add a bit of wind to it, it's going to keep these guys guessing. He's a pitcher that can put it in the zone. And with a bit of a wind, do damage for these batters.
Well, sometimes with the extra movement, it is hard to locate the zone. And three straight balls here from Markia starts off with Keating. And swinging through that one. Got to say, Keating, he's not from our shores, he's from Canada. But his appearance reminds me of a Super Rugby player.
He does, yeah. He looks like Nick Cummings, the Honey Badger.
The Honey Badger. Oh, he would be great in the commentary booth with all the one-liners that come from him. As they pick up a called strike on Keating, he shakes his head but steps back in to go to work.
Just hitting the cleats there. Gets back in the box, old Keating. Markia doesn't like what he's getting. He'll step back. Wants to have a talk to Carson on the mound.
Yeah, he just thinks Keating's taking a little bo peep at the signals from Callum Carson between his legs. And young Keating, only new to New Zealand, and he wouldn't want to do that because, especially in New Zealand, that normally ends up with a bruise somewhere on you.
Oh, the old number five.
The old number five. Eyes forward, young man. See the ball and hit it. Anyway, back into the action. Looking forward now is Keating. 3-2, fooled up. Here comes Markia. The payoff pitch. It's a lifter, and that movement just too much as he peers over to Keating, trotting off. Says, if you're going to look at something, look at that lifter.
Just class from Markia, knowing what he's hitting and what he's not hitting. Just throw that low lifter to get him striking.
Well, you're right, and he's composed. You'd think just been blasted for a home run by Woon before that batter. Instead of getting upset, losing his cool or his rag here, Markia on the hill, he calls time, brings his catcher out, makes sure they're on the same page, don't let him peek at your signals, and then comes back and throws a perfect lifter.
Well, I don't know how many times we've seen a pitcher be hit over the fence and then drop the head, but Markia, even that first one, giving up the three runs, he came back and struck out three players in a row.
Well, Markia knows as well as any other elite ball player in this country, it might be 4-3 in the top of the third, but there is a long, long way to go in this grand final year.
That's right, Chop. Bottom of the second, long way to go.
Carson's set, ready to go. A little something different there from Markia. Pulled the string on a lifter. Hadn't seen that from him yet. He has the change-up that goes down. But this one, just a little lifter curveball action. So Riley Markia saving a little surprise for Carson here on grand final day.
Well, the top pitcher goes into the grand final and still hasn't showed his full arsenal to people. It's awesome.
Oh, there's that drop ball we saw him bring out with yesterday. And it's almost every day he's got something new. Riley Markia walks off and strikes out two batters in a row, but not before Adam Woon blasts one into the hurricane and sails it over the right field fence. They get another run. 4-1. Hutt Valley leading. Bottom three. Coming.
Your ideas, your plans, your vision for your dream home. At Golden Homes, we work with you to create a home you'll love living in. With total design flexibility, our exclusive gold standard building system and Zog steel framing proven to withstand magnitude 9 earthquake activity, your new Golden Home will have all the strength, comfort and sophistication you've been dreaming of.
It's a better home, your own Golden Homes.
Golden Homes. Call 0800 22 22 36.
Welcome back to Fraser Ballpark. You know what? Damien Chopper's got a smile on his dial. We've got rid of the buffering issues. The hurricane is here, but that just makes it exciting. But we've taken care of the internet issues. Touch wood. It stays that way, and we can bring you the rest of this grand final in style. I'm Jason Gerbes, a.k.a. Chopper. Damien Collins with me in the booth. We're partway through this ball game, bottom of the third innings, and it's Wellington's opportunity to get back in it, trailing by 3 runs, and they will have the opportunity to do that from the top of the shop. Dante Matakatia.
It's been outstanding this tournament. Young player out of the PK. Oh, Miramar Club.
That one clips the edge of the strike zone.
Of course, in the top 10 batters of this tournament, Matakatia be looking to add to that total in this game.
Matakatia pops one up. It'll be a Texas leaguer. That's gamemanship, of course. And, sometimes you can see a young baller, and when they make an error, they try to make up for it. And in this particular case, Taina Tiaonui, remember he went let that one come through in the last innings, and in that one, he tried to fire it into second base, had no reason to do that, and he missed the throw, and that allowed Matakatia to go to second base on the overthrow, when he probably should have just taken his time, allowed him the signal, single, and pick his moment to make an impact in this game. You don't have to do everything. Just play your part, Te Aonui, and you'll be just fine. You played well this week.
That's just a high softball IQ right there. He knew the ball was going to go past the second base. He had already kind of rounded first, just pinned his ears back and went because he knew that's what was happening.
Matakatia appearing in from second base as Xavier Herrick, the third baseman, looks to go to work here for the Wellingtonians. 6 hits to 3, Hutt Valley leading that ledge up. They've had half an innings more. And oh boy, I don't know about the hurricane in the wind, but I felt the hurricane off the bat of Herrick. He just swung through at 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, Herrick got a big bat on him. He gunned it down to the third baseline in his first at bat. Keating making the play to first though.
2-1 the count now. Pops this one up, late decision. It'll go foul down the line. Of course, that last swing before that one was on a 2-ball count, so he would have been aggressive for sure.
Xavier Herrick, also another one of Wellington's players in the top batters at this tournament. 8 hits from 22 at bat before today.
2-2 the count now. And Woon just stares it down. Steely face all over him as he picks up a big strikeout of Herrick and doesn't allow Matakatia to be moved over. Herrick missing his assignment there. Riley Markia now picked up the intentional walk, his first trip up. Sees a pitch, first pitch you'll see in this ball game, and that is inside.
Well, I mentioned Adam Woon be a candidate for MVP of this tournament, and you can't go past Riley Markia as well. He's at the top. He's at the top of every list. It's going to be a great tussle between Woon and Markia today.
This one comes on the inside corner. That'll level the count now. The dangerous hitter, Riley Markia. Full swing by Markia. Can't keep up that lifter on the outside edge.
Woon just chucking it down there. Trying to get it past Markia, who gets a tip to it. Foul.
Well, the adrenaline was pumping for the arms of Markia and Woon on the mound. There's a hard hit ball the other way, but it'll go foul. And Markia trying to hit one in the same direction as Woon, going the other way, get it in the jet stream, because that hurricane will take it out of here in no time. Count remains 1-2, of course, Damien.
No, it's one of the things you've definitely seen in this tournament, Chop, is pitchers batting. Back in the day, maybe not, but now it's an all-rounder sport, and these two especially have been outstanding.
Leaning back, takes a big breath. Lifter, it's popped up. Centre fielder's charging. Short Tate, he can't get there. And Matakatia In fairness to him, had no choice. He had to hold up. Being a short taint is electric. And he couldn't get there, though. Fielding deep, that hurricane blowing, and just couldn't quite get there on the pop-up.
I almost think it was a miscommunication between the two, Udy Johns and Short Tate, out there. I think Short Tate running forward thought Udy Johns had it, but of course, with the speed from Short Tate, he should have just pinned the ears back and taken that fly ball.
Well, Craig Wallace, the head coach for the men in green and white, Hutt Valley lads, he isn't happy about something he sees out there. You take Scott Cartwright, and the two of them deliver a message to his men as they have two runners on and only one out here in the bottom of the third innings. They're leading by three. So the sweetest of swings by the, not the tallest man, Zach Boyd, but very, very powerful, will tie up this ball game with one swing.
Yeah, well, we've seen him do it this tournament. I've seen him hit a ball right over the fence with runners on. So he is a danger man, and he can have that power if he needs it.
And he takes the first pitch down the middle, does Boyd. Boyd with the letter P on his helmet.
He does play in the Porirua club there.
This one pops up. Johnson going to the screen. And it comes back in time. Brad Carson will snag it. The wind, that hurricane, that thing was foul and gone for all money. Blows it just inside the line, and Carson makes the grab.
I love the commitment from Jay Johnson. Chucks off the helmet, follows the ball, and with that speed and those leggings, whew, good catching.
Well, Alex London will be up to bat now. That one's down. That'll let them go up 30 feet.
Alex London, another one that has been outstanding this tournament. Top batter going into the last day. 19 at bat with 11 hits. Batting run average of 0.579. He's also on the RBI list with 10.
Well, of course, that'll be 11 because he drove in a run here in the first innings, did London.
And he's also got a couple home runs.
London providing his own auditory on that hit, gave himself a, ooh, I just missed it. Can't keep up with the power on the outside with that drop ball from Woon. Two runners in scoring position now. Matakata at third, remember. Marker at two. Here comes the 1-2. It's the other way, but Woon takes care of it. He'll run over to first base, deliver it to Carson, and eliminate the threat. They'll leave two runners stranded. Well, the Wellingtonians can't get him over, can't get him in. Paul Woon's son, that's Adam, just too good in this one. Top four coming up. 4-1, Hutt Valley lead.
The TAB takes you from wherever you are, right into the race. Melbourne Cup season is here. Join the TAB, deposit $10 and get a $20 bonus with the promo code SPRING. TAB, now you're in the game.
Oh, welcome back to Hutt Valley. Lower Hutt, that is, the home of the Hutt Valley Softball Association. The music is pumpy. The hurricane is rocking. And the O-Falls in the commentary booth got it going on here. Damien Collins joining me. I'm Jason Gubies, a.k.a. Chopper. Chanel Masters, she's the video switcher extraordinaire. Well, Hutt Valley, they have been outstanding with the bat so far in this one. And they have picked up the three runs straight off the bat in the top of the first innings, just electrifying where Hutt Valley. Adam Woon proving very, very lethal home run in the third innings. And they will start with Sage Short Tate, the centre fielder, the dangerous Kaneama Watene Taho, and then Taina Tiao Nui, the left fielder.
Short Tate will be stepping into that box, wanting to rectify a couple of things. He had a KC in that first innings, And he also a couple, not I wouldn't say missed, but dropped in front of him out in the outfield.
Well, Mark here looking to get us started here in the top of the fourth innings. Fouls that back, does short tight. The grandson of Naomi Shaw is Sage, and she was outstanding this week in the commentary booth, and obviously calling colour in the women's final. What a spectacle that was. And with the buffering issues, unfortunately, we had to cut off the feed at the end there. But what we will do tonight is we will reload that game to make sure you get it in its entirety. And it'll be uploaded to the Hutt Valley Softball Facebook page. And boy, oh boy, that one uploaded in the middle of the back of Sage Shaw Tate as he'll go down to first base with a hit pitch.
Speaking of Shaw Tate's grandmother, she many talents. She's up there with the camera now. I wonder if she gets any other players.
Well, Watene Taho will have his turn with Shaw Tate at first base, not out. A threat to run, Shaw Tate. As I was saying, we'll re-upload that grand final for the woman so you can enjoy it. Apologies for the internet issues. That just happens sometimes. I mean, to be fair, it's amazing what you can do with technology these days, but in essence, we're in the middle of a park, miles away from any facility, so being able to bring you this broadcast live is exceptional, and we did everything we could. Oh, perfect sacrifice, but that'll be foul though. Foul called nice and early by the home plate umpire Dave Beaumont. Waitini Taho will come back.
Craig Wallace just questioning where that landed there.
To be fair, it landed about 3 feet in front of Dave Beaumont. If he couldn't see if it was fair or foul from there, he's never going to see it. So yeah, nice bit of respect from Wallace. Asked the question, but then walked back, said fair enough.
Well, he wouldn't be a Wallace if he didn't ask the question.
And Waitini Taho not happy, but more probably just not happy with himself. He's a better hitter, and he knows he's got to protect the strike zone, and he couldn't quite get there. Well, we saw Taina Taonui run over a ball hit to him from bad Brad Carson, and then deliver an errant throw in the last innings. And Craig Wallace says, you've done a fine job for us this week, but we'll let Jono Little take over from here, and he'll make a substitution.
Yeah, Jonathan Little coming into the game, player from the Dodgers Club.
And this player substitution brought to you by Ballpark Broadcasting. So Jonathan Little will take over in the ninth spot here. He'll face Mark here for his first at bat in this one.
Came in that semi-final against Auckland at the right time, batting in a run and almost giving the surgeons that Hutt Valley needed against Auckland in that semi-final.
Down low, the throw, and Shaw Tate takes the invitation, steals the bag.
Yeah, there's not many days you're going to be able to get Shaw Tate on a steal with the speedster that the young man has.
Callum Carson has a gun, but Shaw Tate has got two jetpacks sometimes, it looks like, as he runs around the bases. Exceptionally quick. One down here. That one comes through, clips the edge of the zone.
One of the things I've really been loving this tournament with these young players here, Chopper, is the aggressive base running. We've seen a lot of stolen bases. And even with the guns from the catchers, still giving it a go, even if it's a just pass ball.
Well, it's been exceptional to watch these athletes in attendance here. And to be fair, you just can't put a price on pace, can you, Damien?
No, I wish you could. I would have paid anything.
Stacey Taylor, 100 metre specialist. Well, Jono Little can't get on top of it. Rakia sits him down on strikes. That'll be two in a row now.
They'll bring to bat the top of the order, Jared Gillard, the right fielder.
Well, Jared Gillard's having himself a day here, Damien. Walkers we saw in the first innings come around to score. Then drove one the other way. This one he takes off the twinkle toes. He'll go down with a hit pitch. That's two of them for Markia this innings. Say short date. Tries to go to three on it. He'll have to go back. Nice try, young man.
In fairness to Short Tate, looked like a pass ball all day from this angle. But of course, Gillard saying, yep, it hit my leg. And that one, Beaumont will accept. Catcher Jay Johnson up now. Has been outstanding this tournament, as we've been saying, our man of the match in that semi-final win over Auckland.
Your Jay Johnson, we've seen the rise of him this tournament. He's been one of the new shining stars in my mind. And with a couple of spots left in the New Zealand Black Sox teams to play at the TAB Challenge Cup, you never know, he might just get that phone call from Mark Sorensen.
Johnson leads that one. The 3-1 count now on Johnson. He thought he'd chance that one. Started walking towards one, but no. Strike called from Beaumont.
And cautious was Mark here on Johnson. Picks up the walk. And just like that, Hutt Valley, something cooking, albeit with two down. But they'll send up the big second baseman. Liam Udy-Johns, already with an RBI today, with no space on the base pass, and they'll let Johnson be removed. So the designated runner, I would guess, Hampton. Little, that's the last out, will come out and run for the catcher. There is no room on the bases.
Udy-Johns, the way he's been batting this tournament, he'll try and make some room now. But there's two out.
Hard hit ball goes to second base, and a fine play by Matakatia, shoveling it over to Boyd. Took exception on the slide into second base from Little, and Sadgrove is out there already, and he's giving him a fair decent spray as Matakatia, and Stoddard is out there, the assistant coach. He's telling Wallace to go back to the dugout. Boy, oh boy. The pressure has just lifted here as they finish the top of the fourth innings. David, you look stunned in here, mate. Boy, look, you want to play with passion. You've got to bring it. This is the grand final of the under-23s for New Zealand, Damien. What a great game.
And you're also playing the guys that you're going to see down in your intercity game on the Saturday. Oh, lots of passion here that Fraser won for this under-23 grand final.
Well, fantastic. Good to see. And we'll duck away now for a break. 4-1 is the scoreline, and the passion is flowing.
We Add Star, the Saturday morning sports show.
Have you ever hit a home run?
Yeah, I've hit a couple, mate, because I always used to be let the first one go by. Never get the player of the day.
For local sports talk from a local perspective, tune in to the Atiawa Toa FM Saturday morning sports show.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Fraser Park for this grand final matchup in the Under-23 National Championships between Hutt Valley and Wellington.
Just wait till I get set up before you cross to me. Let Damien throw to me. Well, Damien's going to introduce me, and then you'll go to my camera. Name of Craig.
Jaden Stratford, sorry guys, we've just been all a bit sorting a few things out and we've missed, but we've got it. Jaden Stratford sends one over the fence for a home run. That will excite Chanel Masters here in the booth. And Wellington will get another run, take the score to 4-2 at this time. Was crossed to Chopper, who's got Craig Wallace from Hutt Valley.
Yeah, thank you, Damien. Well, we're ringside here, halfway through this matchup. Hutt Valley off to an amazing start here. Three runs in the first, one in the third. And I'm joined by the head coach for Hutt Valley, Craig Wallace. What do you think about the start?
Oh, yeah, we're hoping to jump out early, so we got in charge. And just made, I guess we made Riley throw some strikes and we jumped on what we needed to jump on. Long way to go.
First rodeo, Craig, it's great to see you giving back to this under-23 level, the passion that comes out of it, it looks exciting to watch.
Yeah, well, I mean, we got a pretty young team, so just trying to keep them composed sort of the side of through to the game, but yeah, they're very passionate, obviously, and just trying to harness that.
Well, okay, with a lead halfway through the game here, what does Hutt Valley have to do to stay in the lead and to secure the win?
We just got to work from in front, not get behind there. They've got a great hitting lineup, so we just need to work. We need to make sure we work here and keep compiling runs. We got to just get behind there to make our plays and keep working in front.
Well, fantastic. Craig Wallace, the head coach, thank you for your time there. Well, we are halfway through this one and a great matchup. This one's up and it's deep and that's gone. Wellington with another home run here. It just doesn't stop. This is one of the best finals I've seen in a long time. Back to you into the booth, Damien.
Thank you. Thank you, Chopper. Wow. We have a game on our hands here. Wellington with two home runs to start their fourth innings. One to Jaden Stratford, one to Damon Creasy. Wellington coming back with style against the Hutt Valley. Hutt Valley still leading this one 4-3. But man, do we have a game on our hands. Little conference talk with Hutt Valley management and their team that will bring to bat 84. Cullen Carson drilled it to the outfield last at bat.
Did you come back to it?
Jay Johnson just goes out to talk to Adam Warren, calming down a bit. And they'll be looking to hold their lead here, Hutt Valley. Of course, none out. Just the two batters face, Callum Carson the third, two home runs already of this innings. Callum Carson set, Adam Woon into the windup now. The pitch, Carson drills it, foul, down the third baseline. Coach will pop it up to Keating coming through.
I'll do an interview with Thing on the end of this innings.
And Carson, 1-1 call.
Oh, what a ball game, Damien. And back in the booth, and this one's up. Is it in the jet sweep? I believe it is. He's going to the fence, and it's over! And it's over! Callum Carson, the catcher from Wellington, just laces it over the fence just in time. Sage Shaw Tate collides with the fence goes down, and boy, oh boy, oh boy, we've got ourselves an amazing ball game.
Wow, just wow. Adam Woon, outstanding all tournament, and I'm not saying he hasn't been in this game, but three straight batters have hit him over the fence in this innings to draw the game 4-4. We'll just go to check the out.
What an amazing stroke from Callum Carson. And the umpires have ruled a ground rule double. Hold your horses. Send them back to the stable. Callum Carson bounces it over. We saw the fence, the collision of Shaw Tate on the fence, and the ball land, and in our mind, everyone's waving their arms in centre field. What are you doing? The second base umpire, that is Ben Dyson, rules a ground rule double. He's saying the ball landed in the field of play. Shaw Tate, the centre fielder, runs through the fence trying to make the catch above his head. Somehow, he says the ball lands in the field of the play, then goes out after the fence has been knocked over. Could that be the call of the century? We'll soon find out. Still one run lead now for Hutt Valley.
Well, in the batter's box now, number 92, right fielder Andre Hart. He's in the top batters of this tournament with RBIs. And he bounced. Hits it back to Adam Woon, who makes a play to Carson at first for the first out of the innings.
Well, the exciting thing about the under 23 level, Damien, is how these men are so athletic. Somehow Woon gets to that. The pitcher tosses it over just in time as he bites the dirt. The pitcher taking one for the team, knowing he needs to get the out for his province.
Of course, Callum Carson has moved to third base on that play. He's in scoring position. Matakatia, the leadoff for Wellington, looking to drive him in.
Oh, Matakatia, one of the spark plugs in this team. And we saw him being aggressive out there. Well, not aggressive, but standing up for his teammates in the field as they came from the field at the end of the last innings.
Heated.
And the passion is flowing. The blood is boiling. Johnny Stratford just asking him to keep his head here. Execute. And execute he does. He goes up the middle, does Matakatia, and he'll drive in Carson, who should have been home already, to be fair. And that'll tie up the ball game now, 4-4.
In the fourth, we've got a 4-4 ball game here. Wellington just coming back with the stick in this innings. Two automatics, one bouncing over and now being driven in by Matakatia. Wellington have definitely picked up the pace here late in the fourth innings.
Well, that'll bring up now Xavier Herrick, a third baseman. And down to third base, that'll be foul though, taking him foul territory from the third baseman Keating. And the home plate umpire right there on the spot, Dave Bowman, also Robbie Sadgrove behind him, indicating it was taken in foul territory.
Yep, Keating fast, even able to get it when it goes foul. Good third baseman in the hot corner.
Well, this one's got a bit of everything, Damien.
Oh, doesn't it just chop?
And this one is a Texas leaguer, that'll fall. Off goes Matakatia, had to hold up because he thought he was going to make the catch. There's only one down, remember. Good base running. So runners at one and two now. And up comes the big guy.
Udy Johns just over his head for that one. Usually nothing gets past him, but in the gap, just where it needs to be for Xavier Herrick to get on base and move Matakatia to scoring position.
Well, I got to tell you, Damien, when you're needing to pick up some intensity in the game, sometimes someone needs to do something. Sometimes someone needs to push the button. And in my mind, Dante Matakatia is that man. At the end of the innings, he stands up for his teammates. and Wayne Stoddard comes charging out of the dugout, and it's a spray between the coaches and the players. And what's the result of it? Three runs so far for Wellington in the bottom of the fourth.
Sometimes you just need that chop, someone to just fire up the team and get the blood boiling. Matakatea, heated, if would be one word, was basically dragged off the diamond. But the turnaround in this Wellington side and this innings, driving in three runs, outstanding.
Well, Adam Warren looking to settle things down here with the ever-dangerous Rolly Markia. Up the bat here, one and two, the count on him.
We'll see how Woon comes back here. Of course, we've seen Markia give up a couple of runs and come back and strike out people. You know, that ball goes straight into Markia's back. He twisted so far that it bounced off the bat into him.
Does indeed. It's one of those ones you don't like to see as a player. He just fell, tips that one off, goes straight into the thigh. Does Rolly Markia. And instantly he says, no, I'm okay, I'm fine, I'm okay. He's not. He's just taking one for the team.
Yep, the old dust it off and walk it off. Mark here, tough character this in this game.
Inside, Mark here being tested. Just fouls one into his leg. Woon then just plants a drop ball not far off it. So Mark here, breathing heavily in the batter's box. Rise ball sails on the outside. Looked like a mislocation to me. Johnson set up on the inside. Rise ball spins to the out. Remember, more movement here.
Two and two, the count.
Mark. Pop. Watiti Toho underneath him. But he takes it like it's a still day. Watiti Toho, one of the best fielders out there.
Caught by Watini Toho for the second out of this innings. That will bring to bat number 44, the shortstop, Zach Boyd. Small man with a bit of power when he needs it. Just allow Damien to keep on talking. Called strike on Zach Boyd.
Oh, Zach Boyd working hard here.
You're on one count. Big swing and a miss for strike two.
Three runs scored so far in the bottom of the fourth innings. Two down, but still two ducks on the pond here for Wellington.
That's right. Runners at one and two for Wellington.
That one fouls back off the screen. Bit of attention at centre field. Remember, Shaw Tate ran through the fence on the ruled ground rule double. And unfortunately, the fence landed on one of the spectators just lying behind it, but he's up and okay now. The medics are with him. He's fine, albeit a bit of an ice pack on his forehead.
One of the better hits I've seen at Fraser Park.
Oh, this one's hit hard. Zach Boyd laces it. One bounce hits the fence. In comes one. Here comes two. Zach Boyd says, out of my watch. And Wellington have the first lead of the ball game. They now lead 6 runs to 2.
That's
six runs
right.
to four, apologies.
6 runs to 4. Wellington take the lead here late in the fourth innings with that huge hit. One bounce hitting the fence for Zach Boyd, hitting the scoring the two RBIs and setting up shop safe on two for himself.
Well, the young man originally from Hooks Bay, Adam Woon, with a 1.63 ERA, 30 innings, only 7 runs given up in the whole tournament. He's just given up 6 now in the grand final. When does Craig Wallace think about a change?
Maybe soon.
Well, maybe, maybe not. We'll soon find out. Those are always the penultimate questions as a coach. When do you make a move? When do you not?
This is it. Adam Woon, a serious customer on that mound, professional in his own right, will come be, look to come back here and show his true grit and retire the side.
Well, he just drilled that one on the inside edge. Here comes the 1-1, and it's a drum ball up the middle, and Watini Te Hau too silky smooth for that. He'll toss him out over in time.
There was an out that Hutt Valley needed, but in the fourth innings, a home run to Jaden Stratford, a home run to Damon Creasy, a two-bagger, one bounce and over the fence to Cullum Carson, driven in another couple runs. Wellington go to the bottom of the fifth innings, or top of the fifth inning, sorry, leading this one 6-4.
Hey, bud. Let's go away. We'll go. It's over here, but I'm just worried about the wind. Do you mind if we take it all the way to the five booth? It's just protected over there. Not a bad time to get you in too, eh?
You are watching the grand final between Auckland. Between Wellington and Hutt Valley here on Diamond One of Fraser Ballpark. Fourth day, game 48 in the schedule. The last one. We're going to cross the chopper. Who's got the Wellington coach now?
Yes, thank you, Damien. I've got Johnny Stratford, the head coach from Wellington here. And boy, oh boy, this game has got a bit of everything. Passion and power. Hutt Valley, they come out with passion and get it started in the first innings there, score all those runs. They get the lead. Then at the bottom of the last innings, Johnny Stratford's men, they stand up and blast the ball over the place and give yourself the lead. What a great innings.
Yeah, great innings, mate. It was just a matter of time. We just had to stay calm. Boys were getting a little excited in the first couple of innings, and just had to stay calm, you know. They've got good sticks and have good at-bats, and good things will come.
Well, we were thinking in the commentary booth that you needed a bit of something. You needed a bit of something to get you going there. Dante Matakatea took an exception to a slide going to second base at the end of the innings before that. Seemed to be the tipping point to get the boys fired up. Do you think that made a difference?
Yeah, listen, possibly. I don't think there was too much in it, but got Dante up and it got the boys up and we came out smashing the ball, and that's what it's about.
Well, you're up now, Johnny, and you're over halfway through this game. What do you need to do to secure the win?
Stay calm in the defensive side of things and keep getting up and swinging at strikes. That's the name of the game, and good things will keep happening.
Well, good things are happening. Johnny Stratford, the head coach for Wellington. They're in the lead here in the final of the under-23s. Back to you, Damien, in the booth.
Thank you, Chopper. We go back to our plane now with Adam Woon in the box. He's got three balls, and that swing and a miss will be strike one. So three balls, one strike on Adam Woon. Of course, Woon has been batting the ball this game, hit a homer in his last at-bat. And he's given up a few runs with the pitching, so he'll be wanting to get over that home plate again. With the walk, he will take first base, and that will bring to bat the third baseman, Cole Keating. Cole Keating has been outstanding on that third base. He got on first at bat, last at bat got struck out. With Hutt Valley giving it up a few runs in that last innings, so they'll be looking to make this innings count very much. And the first offering to Keating is a cool strike. Wide stance from Keating lowers that strike zone. Ball high will even the count 1-1. Keating, a Canadian born over here, playing some ball for the Hutt City United Club. Looks a little bit like the Honey Badger. He's got the curly hair. I wonder if he's got some good yarns too.
Well, I'm sure he's got plenty of good yarns here, the Honey Badger, but left to save him for his next at bat because Riley Barkier sends him back to the dugout with his tail between his legs. Great getting insight from the two head coaches, Craig Wallace and Johnny Stratford.
both after both teams had given them an extra lead. But those five runs by Wellington in the bottom of the fourth innings, boy, oh boy, oh boy, talk about putting a charge into one. 6-4 the scoreline now. Wellington leading Hutt Valley in the top of the fifth innings.
We've got a game, Chopper. We've got a game.
We sure do indeed, my friend. And this one comes through on the outside edge.
Carson in the hole early, on to the count. He's been struck out twice already. Carson is better player than this. He'll be wanting to do something with the bat.
We're in the middle of an emotionally charged grand final, and it's all going on here. One ball comes down low, and a return to Riley Markia. And he just paints the inside corner, and that'll send Brad Carson back to the dugout, just like his fellow teammate Keating. Two strikeouts in a row here for the man from Wellington. Sage Shaw-Tate, he'll be the new batter coming up now. Got to say, my scorebook, it looks like a three-year-old's been writing it. I'm not used to doing it the old school way. Glad we've got a nice score running. Great scorers here from New Zealand. And that ball just missing the belly button of the strike zone. That happens sometimes. Sage Shaw-Tate, the batter, smiles. He acknowledges it was down the middle. He got away with one. They'll go back to the action. Down low. That one's a proper ball. Sage Shaw-Tate, the benefactor of three straight balls now. You put him on first base, and he's already has one stolen bag here this game. And with four straight balls, that'll be all the invite he needs to try and pick up another one. That'll move Woon over to second base. So two runners on here, two down. And I bring up the heavy hifting, Kiriyama, Wateneteho.
The big shortstop has been struck out looking twice at his bat today. We're looking to change that now that they're behind in the count on the scoreboard.
Well, he's got a nice quiet demeanor, does Wateneteho, silky smooth with the glove. And he'll look to be silky smooth here with the bat as he allows that other another delivery to go outside the zone. Six straight balls delivered by Markia now. Four to Sage Shaw-Tate. Two to Wateneteho. He swings over the top of that green, lighting himself, and taps his helmet, says, "You're better than that."
Yeah, he had already almost pre-told himself that he was going to do that. Big swing for strike one.
Well, it's a two-run lead here in the top of the fifth innings with two ducks on the pond. Wateneteho knows he can get the lead for his province. That lifter on the inside edge is devastating as it clips the edge of the zone. And for Wateneteho, that'll be the hood. Three strikeouts in a row. Well, that'll do. The top of the fifth innings seem to quieten down a little bit with the passion and the action as these two teams are trying to sort themselves out who will be the national champion. Back to you shortly. Top six coming. More action. Welcome back to Fraser Ballpark. Just as the water bottle was about to pass the lips, we come back. Thank you, Chanel Masters. Always keeping us on task, Damien, don't you think?
Oh, most definitely. Most definitely. But it's a bit weird to see you late in the tournament without a beer in your hand yet, the chopper.
Well, you know, we're all professionals here, and I've got to say we are in the Sahara at the moment. But that's okay because we've got ourselves an exceptional ball game going at the moment. Jaden Stratford, he steps in to go to work, ground out his first at-bat, but boy, oh boy, did he get a hold of one in his last at-bat. He started that charge in the bottom of the fourth innings, blasting a home run over centre field.
He most definitely did start that rally. Three batters. We'll check that one. Went past the wrist.
He did indeed. Well, Ben Horn down at first base adjudicates that's a swing. And Stratford just giving time because Wayne Stoddard, I tell you, he got heated when Matakatia got approached by Wallace, the coach from the opposing team. Oh, he's got another one. It's in the jet stream. This is going back, back, back. Oh, baby, oh, baby. This one will not land inside the field. Stratford goes back to back with another jack. Wellington lead it by three.
Wow, just over the fence as well. You couldn't get more precision than that. Hitting a home run at it's two in a row, just when Wellington need that extra run to get ahead.
Well, you dream of things when you get to a grand final growing up, of hitting a home run to win it for your team. What about hitting two?
What about hitting two? I'd like to hit one.
Well, Damon Greasy will come in. He'll want to hit one himself here. Will the centre fielder for Wellington. And, of course, the centre fielder has already hit one, so he could hit two. Ground out and a home run. The middle end of the order has some sting in it for the Wellingtonians.
Well, Creasy might be looking back at Stratford and going, whatever you do, I might want to do better. So let's see what he can bring to it.
11 hits from Wellington, 7 runs.
Too high for Creasy.
Second best pitcher here in attendance, Adam Woon, still out there on the mound.
Adam Woon's lost a bit of his coolness on the mound.
Stacey Taylor just checking the bullpen for us for Hutt Valley. And up in the bullpen was the original scheduled starter, Braden Hampton. Thank you, Stacey Taylor. Yep, that one down low. This one's up in the jet stream. It's going back to the track. And Sage Shortate will corral it in. Not quite high enough. The Hurricane couldn't save the day for Greasy to go back to back. The New Zealand flag is flying strong at centre field. It is blowing a gale going out. Boy, oh boy, the fireworks are happening here.
I honestly thought there was another one, Chop. Went straight up, got a great swing behind it. But just sitting up for Shortate to make that routine catch at centre field.
Well, Callum Carson will come in the bottom of the fourth innings. It should have been back-to-back-to-back home runs for Stratford, Greasy and Carson. But second base official Ben Dyson rules it a ground rule double somehow. Carson takes care of this one. It's a line drive, one bounce, hits the top rail of the fence and comes back in. I bet you he turns to the second base umpire and says, you know what, that's a double.
Yeah, you can't question that one, Chief. No, definitely almost went over, hitting the top rail of that Black Sox sign that's sitting out there at centre field, making the outfielders Shortate work for it.
Well, Andre Hart with a sacrifice bunt to go with his first trip was a strikeout. He'll step in to go to work next. Carson in scoring position at two. Only one out here in the bottom of the fifth. Insurance run in already, 7-4 the scoreline.
Andre Hart, already one of the top batters of the tournament with RBIs, has already added to his total in this game.
That one comes off the foot, bat first. That'll make the ball dead. But I don't know about you watching at home, ladies and gentlemen, but this one's got a bit of everything.
Well, it certainly does, Chopper. 4-1 down. Wellington have come back to lead this game 7-4.
Up top, Hart shakes his head.
And they're looking comfortable here late in the fifth innings.
Says no, comes off the glove of Johnson. Played umpire Beaumont indicates the wound. It was outside with the flick of the mask. I love that about an umpire, to be fair. He just indicates straight away, tilts the head up or down or to the side where he thinks the ball has missed the strike zone. 2-2 now. And a swing and a miss from Andre Hart. And wound sits him down. Of course, with that pass ball that allowed Carson to go down to third base, but he won't be needed there anymore because it's two outs, and they will send out the last out, so Andre Hart won't go into the dugout. He'll go to third base and run for the catcher, Carson.
That was a strikeout that Adam Woon needed. Just, I think, a little bit more confidence because it looks like Hutt Valley have been putting their head down with the rally that Wellington have come back with.
Well, Dante Matakatia has had a horrible day today. He sparked the Wellington offense, did that from the field, and he's gone 3-from-3 with three signals. He's brought his A game today.
And also with the glove at second base, he's been outstanding.
Well, that's what you want from your leadoff man. That one comes through on the inside of the zone. That'll level the count now.
Wellington with a runner in scoring position.
Ball low, great catching by Jay Johnson.
Absolutely fantastic catching from Jay Johnson to catch it in the dirt.
Yep, saves that one for sure. Got to say, this artificial turf, though, catcher's dream to block those balls in the dirt. There is no weird bounces whatsoever. Check swing from Matakatia. Boy, oh boy, his teammates. Even check swings get a whoo. They're up for it.
And that's the great thing, Chop, here at the under 23 grand final. You can see that these boys playing for their province are really wanting it.
Well, everyone's on the edge of their seats here in this one. Matakati gets one on the handle. That'll go foul. Fraser Ballpark is packed. And they're everywhere along the bank. See one section of the bank. They're about 6 or 7 deep. It's an impressive sight to see here at Fraser Ballpark. Remember, this is not the NFC level. This is the under 23. Softball New Zealand in good stead.
Absolutely outstanding tournament this weekend, showcasing our under 23 talent in the men's and the women's here at Fraser Park. It's been a dream.
It goes up, this flares up in the air, going for it. The left fielder, of course, that's right field if I get my hands right, single. That'll be Gillard. He comes in and makes the catch, does Jared, and that'll complete the bottom of the fifth innings. No, not before. Jaden Stratford says, I can do it once. Well, guess what? I can do it twice. Blast one out of the park. Two home runs, Jaden Stratford, here this evening. 7-4 is the scoreline. Now the top six comes when we come back. An amazing grand final here in the top of the sixth innings. And amazing because it has been full of everything. Full of passion, full of power, full of runs. 11 of them, in fact, 4 of them to Hutt Valley. They picked up 3 in the first. Wellington responded with 1 in the bottom of the first innings. 1 in the top of the third, and then 5 in the bottom of the fourth. Boy, oh boy, that was a treat to watch. Another one here in the bottom of the fifth. That gives us the scoreline. 7-4. It's an exceptional ball game, and also looked after by exceptional sponsors. Just want to say Construction Contracts Limited to supplying the commentary booth for this one, keeping us out of that Gale Force win. Thank you to you for your sponsorship of this event. Te Atiawa is the other one. You'll see their adverts come up within the broadcast anyway. Thank you for your sponsorship of the Under 23 National Tournament for Softball New Zealand, hosted by the Hutt Valley Softball Association. Well, Jono Little, he will get him started here for Hutt Valley, trailing by 3 runs in the top of the 6 innings. First one goes foul. Got everything going, music playing during the game and everything. It's a festival, Damien. It's a festival.
Well, softball should be. It's a summer sport. It's a beautiful game. Let's enjoy it more.
Buzzing the tower. It's Iceman. Buzzing the tower in the F-16. Tom Cruise. Top Gun. That's what we're looking for. Wow, that one, man, just missed the helmet.
Little ready for some limbo later.
Jono Little's like, wow. How am I supposed to go over and hit that drop or hard on the outside corner after you just shaved my upper lip? Boy, oh boy. Picture perfect. Riley Markey is still out there. Hard ground ball goes the other way, but that'll be foul before the two home run hitting champion, Jaden Stratford, corrals it in.
Well, we've mentioned some of the facial here in this tournament, and maybe someone should shave that top lip off Jono Little.
Well, Jono Little, not so little anymore. Trying to grow the manscaping. But he'll be happy with a hit, because that's what Hutt Valley need now. They're trailing on the hit count. 6-12. 12 hits for Wellington. Wow, wow, wow.
Well,
it's only 3 runs difference. That's what he's going to be thinking about now. Just get on base and allow this Hutt Valley team to drive the ball and letting that low lifter come through. Jono Little will have to go back to the dugout and pass the baton over to Jared Gillard.
Well, Chopper, one of my nicknames has always been DC, but always was Casey as well because of the amount of strikeouts that I would leave. I don't understand why a number of these boys are going back to the dugout, shaking their head when every strikeout called has been in the same place.
Well, the number 9 spot in the lineup has not been hospitable for the Hutt Valley men. Tao Nui was the starter in the number 9 spot. He struck out, and then since Little has taken over, he's struck out twice. So number 9 not getting anything other than out by swings. Gillard, though, he's been a different story at the top of the shop. A walk, a single, and hit by pitch. He's been on base every single time.
He wants a Gillard, a quality player playing in the right field. Part of the Dodgers club, so this is his home field. He'll be wanting to start the rally that Hutt Valley desperately needs to come back in this grand final.
You'll know the Gillards are here in attendance. Donna Gillard, gotta love her. When you see her face, just as a smile on your dial, the scorer for Softball New Zealand, official scorer. She was the scorer for the Temper Zone Junior Black Sox that went to Prince Albert, that Jared Gillard was one of the members of. Well, anyway, back to the action here. Gillard family in attendance watching Jared go to work. Drop ball on the outside edge, and it's an effort ball from Markia as he grunts that one through. Here comes the 1-2. It's a change-up. That's unfair. That is unfair. Riley Markia just burns a low lifter on the outside edge that he can't keep up with and then throws him on the front foot with a change-up. Markia looking strong. Back-to-back strikeouts here in the top of the 6. And up next will be Jay Johnson, the catcher.
Gillard with the big smile on his face. Hook, line, and sinker with that change-up.
Inside, grounds out. Johnson not happy with it, and he will allow Wellington to go off the field as he grounds out there to finish the top of the 6th inning. Bottom of the 6th coming, and sure, it's time for sure for Wellington. They lead by 3. 7-4. We'll be back with the bottom of the 6th.
We and Star, the Saturday morning sports show.
Have you ever hit a home run?
Yeah, I hit a couple, mate, because I always used to be let the first one go by. Can't forget the player of the day.
For local sports talk from a local perspective, tune in to the Atiawa Toa FM Saturday morning sports show.
Well, welcome back to the melting pot of emotion, power and passion. That is the Under-23 National Championship from Sofwell, New Zealand here at Fraser Park in Lower Hutt, New Zealand. I'm Jason Gerbes, a.k.a. Chopper. Stacey Taylor, the ground announcer on this one, doing a fine job out there in the wind. Chanel Masters, video switcher extraordinaire. And my man, a man with a deep, deep, deep voice. Wait a minute, a deep, deep, deep shot. No, coming forward is Sage Shore Tate as Herrick will fly out for the first out here in the six innings. Well, let me come back to the man with a deep, deep, deep voice. Just lay that speaker down on the lounge floor. Turn up the bass because Damien Collins in the booth calling colour.
Yeah, thanks, Chopper.
Even
that actually hurt.
Tommy Downs is here. Great to see him anytime. My man. Still waiting for that tamoko. Sure it's only a matter of time.
Anytime. I've got two from Tom. Are you not on the list?
No. Chopper will be looking for that one that's given with a koha, though. That's the reason, I think. Grounds out to third base. Keating's backhands it, throws it over in time, and record the ground out of Riley Markia. Zach Boyd will be up next with two outs here in the bottom of the six innings, moving quickly now through this ball game.
Cole Keating, outstanding on that third baseline. They call it the hot corner because everything coming down is with power, and Keating hasn't flinched once. The Honey Badger on three.
The Honey Badger getting it done for Hutt Valley in the corner. Well, the shortstop for Wellington hasn't been too bad either. Fielder's choice fly out, and then a double. Two RBIs on the day for Zach Boyd. This one low. And moves the count now. Two balls to the shortstop from Wellington. That one comes down the kitchen sink, though. Boyd tries to check.
Yeah, it's got a rise from Dallas Parker in the front. Cheering on Boyd.
In the bottom of the six, Wellington are definitely looking insurance run time here. Overthrow and drop ball from Woon. Nice catching from Johnson. Drop ball above the head of Boyd. 2-1 the count now. Apologies, of course, it's 3-1. Fouled off. Full swing from Boyd. That'll fill up the count.
Boyd smacked it to the back fence in the last innings. Full up count here. He's very capable.
And so is Woon as he matches him with a drop ball on the outside that Boyd can't keep up with. They come up 1-2-3 in the bottom of the six innings. They go down 1-2-3. Adam Woon gets his men back in the dugout. Top seven coming. Last chance Sunday. Can they do it? We'll be back very shortly.
Yeah.
Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Fraser Ballpark. We're up to the top of the seventh innings. Wellington with a lead three outs for the ball game. I'd like to take the opportunity to thank a few people. Angela Johnson, the tournament organiser. Glenn Roth, the Softball New Zealand delegate. Umpire in chief is Mark McFarlane. Chief scorer is Christine Eden. Statistician is Joe Hyde. Men's selector, Stevie Deans. Women's selector, Stan Doney. The umpires in attendance this week: Heidi Leithart, Ricky Thompson, Mark Undrell, Ben Dyson, Robbie Sadgrove, Sam Michael, Dave Beaumont, Ben Horn, Ray Dyson, Liz Kawana, John Hickman, and Whitamu Tamaki supporting as well. That's 13 of them. Donna Gillard, Leanne Harris, Gilzel Bishop, Elaine Hiroki, Tobias Charnley, Margaret Marsh, and Karen Walford are the official scorers in this one. We thank you for your time and your volunteering here at the Under 23 National Championship for Softball New Zealand at Fraser Ballpark. Well, first ball delivered, it hits the dirt to Udi Johns. He's one from three with a single, ground out, and a fielder's choice. That one comes down Main Street this time. That'll level the count on the second baseman from the Hutt Valley. So it comes through the zone. I tell you what, I was going to say this before. Riley Marker, he's hilarious. He had a bad throw from Kellen Carson, went down low, and he took time about two innings ago. He says, "Look, mate, just throw it to my glove. That's all you got to do, you know? No big deal. It's only a grand final. Take it easy." Last throw back from Carson, Marker walked about halfway down the track. So, can you make this one, bud? Can you make it? Riley Marker, devastating in the batter's box. Devastating on the pitcher's mound, but still a character. And he gets him. Righty Mark here shows he's devastating on the mound and picks up the first out here in the seventh innings as he sits down Udi Johns on strikes. Well, they've been at each other all tournament, Damien. The two pitchers, the two heavy hitters, Adam Woon and Riley Mark here, and it comes down to them here.
Yeah, Woon has been on the mound all game. Of course, they're down in the count on the runs. Woon will be looking at be that ignition for Hutt Valley that they need to fire up in this last at-bat.
Well, he's been perfect today in the batter's box. Adam Woon, a single home run and a walk, two from two. He'll be looking for three from three, I'm sure. And he just missed it. A change-up from Markia. Left it hanging, Woon underneath it. That would have gone a long, long way.
Yeah, about an inch higher, and it would have gone over that left fence very easily, I reckon.
But in the hole now is Woon. No balls and two strikes. A chance to utilise the outside of the strike zone. And he doesn't need to. Markia does not need to. The low lifter on the outside corner picks up the second out of the innings, and just like that, in the blink of an eye here in the seventh innings, Wellington, one out away from being national champions.
That's right, Chopper. Just the one out. Wellington leading this one 7-4 over Hutt Valley. Last chance for Hutt Valley to come in and make something happen here in the seventh.
Cole Keating steps in to go to work. The Honey Badger. To be fair, every kid who's got long hair this week has been getting it from us, hasn't he?
Well, from you especially.
You gave him the Honey Badger name, not me.
Well, that's because he looks like the Honey Badger.
Me under the bus. Let's just throw every kid with long hair under the bus. Have you seen?
I hope they don't listen back to these. Yeah, glass houses, Chop, glass houses. Yeah,
fair enough. This one gets the outside edge. And we're back in the action here, two down. Honey Badger up the plate here.
Is that a great glove this whole game? You almost want him to get a hit after everything he's
low
done.
Low from the Honey Badger, trying to take the rise ball out of it. And the drop ball missing underneath. That'll move the count now, 2-1. Markey's go-to pitch is the low lifter. Honey Badger just calls time. Take a moment. Loving the big stage here. Checks his red helmet. I'll tell you what. It just looks like it matches that green uniform.
Be the first time we see a lot of these names on the big stage, but I guarantee it won't be the last.
You're right. Here we go. Here comes the 2-1 low lifter. Best pitch from Markia all tournament, and he clips the outside edge with it to level the count.
Is it? Can people not see it? Like, it's the one that they keep on leaving.
Riley Markia has got an amazing low lifter. Will it be the pitch that finishes it? One strike away from a national championship. They're at the gate, Wellington, ready to bolt. Here it comes, and just missing the top of the zone. That low stance from the Honey Badger works. We have a full count. They will have to wait at the gate one more pitch. Brad Carson, one pitch away from having a turn if called upon in the warm-up circle. Keating waiting. Counter's full. Here comes Markia. It's a drop ball this time, and it's a ground ball. Goes to Matakatia, and Wellington win! And Wellington win! It's a dog pile on the pitcher's mound. Wellington win the grand final. 7 runs to 4. Riley Markia strikes out 2 in the 7th. The weak ground ball finishes it off. But oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. It'll be celebration time in the capital city of New Zealand, Damien.
Yes, it will, Chopper. Wellington taking this under-23 tournament out, beating their neighbours, Hutt Valley. Oh, what a game. Had a bit of everything, didn't it, Chop?
It sure did, my friend. An amazing ball game. And I tell you, you'll want to watch that one again because it had everything. Hutt Valley come out in the first inning. Blast 3 runs. Shock Wellington. Wellington pick up one in the bottom of the first. Hutt Valley get another one in the top of the third. And then the altercation. The slide into 2. Matakati is not happy. They come out of the dugout. Stoddard and Wallace have words. Then 5 runs replied in the bottom of the 4th innings. That's how they got going, Wellington. That, in my mind, was the big, big difference offensively. They saw another one in the bottom of the 5th. 12 hits, 7 runs does Wellington, and they run out national champions, 7 runs to 4. We'll be back shortly. We'll allow Damon to finish off here. I want him to thank the 04 commentary crew. I'm going to duck out. We'll grab the player of the match and bring him in for an interview.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, we just had to swap over headsets. Now, as Chopper said, we'd like to thank the 04 commentary crew. Firstly, thank you to everyone that joined us over the last 4 days to watch our live stream. Although Chopper does a lot of effort to get this game out there, it takes a lot of people to log in and make it worth it by listening. So thank you everyone that's tuned into our live stream over the last few days. So our 04 commentary team consists of a few people. We've had Joe Ferrezio on colour, and he's also been ground announcing. Chanel Masters and Dallas Parker have been helping us out in the booth with the video switching. Both ladies been doing an absolutely amazing job. Can't wait to work with them again at the PK Classic this year. We've had Stacey Taylor in and out of the booth. He did the ground announcing for the final today. We've had the legend herself, Naomi Shaw. She's been in the booth helping out with the women's games yesterday and, of course, the grand final today. Gary Rauhihi was on and helping out as well. Of course, listen, a massive, massive shout-out to Chopper, Jason Gerbes, for all the work that he does in our game, promoting our game and bring it to the masses, bringing his own iPads down to the ground and getting it out there for you. And I guess we could thank me as well, but we won't. Rick Shaw, Makara, he was also in the booth, and that is our 04 commentary team. We come down because we want to, because we love the game, and we also like to talk a bit of muck. We're just waiting on Chopper, who has our man of the match, wherever he is out there. He's just letting the teams have a little chat. He's letting the teams have a catch up after that hell of a final here win. Grand final here at the under-23 national championships. Of course, Wellington taking it out over their neighbours, Hutt Valley, winning this one 7-4. And what a game it was. Had a bit of everything. Well, Hutt Valley were up 4-1. And then in the fourth innings, a little altercation on the field sparked the comeback for Wellington, who came back to win this one in style. 12 hits, 7 runs. Absolutely fantastic work.
I'm going to get our mark from here. I'm going to go for it.
And we're just waiting now. It looks like Chopper has picked his man of the match.
You tell us
and
when
we cross. We're crossing live now to Chopper.
Well,
Jason
welcome,
Gerbes,
ladies and gentlemen. What an amazing grand final here. The under-23 national champion all over. Who's the champions? Wellington. With me is Dante Maricatia. Congratulations, Dante. What an amazing final.
Yeah. You know, the Hutt Valley boys, they had a long way to get here, and they done it. And they come out firing, you know, scoring those early three runs. And then, you know, the boys dug deep, you know, keep chipping away. And then, you know, we got those three home runs. And then,
oh, they're going to win it.
Ball game right there.
Well, Dante, watching the game, you were outstanding in the batter's box, but we felt at the end of the third innings you took exception to one of your teammates with a hard slide into two. That sparked your team. That sparked the offense. We thought you were the player of the match. Did you think that was a pivotal moment in the game?
Yeah. You know, the boys, you know, they looked like they were taking a back step to these guys. And, you know, we looked at ourselves right here, and we don't take a back step to anyone. So, you know, we picked out our nuts, and then, you know, we went from there.
Well, you climb the mountain and you reach the summit. National champions, how does that make you feel?
Oh, you know, it's been a while since we won something. Good, you know, Auckland been up on us a couple of years, and you know, we're just like you know, the Rambler boys ain't here, you know, we'll take it. So yeah.
Well, there you go, Wellington. They are reign supreme for 2019, the under-23 national champions, and the player of the match in my mind, Dante Maricatia. Congratulations. I'll let you go back and celebrate with your teammates.
Thank you.
All right, Damien, back to you in the booth. What an amazing final.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us in this grand final here at the under-23 national championships here at Fraser Park. Be sure to check all the results from this tournament. They will be on the Softball New Zealand website and the Hutt Valley Softball Facebook page. If you want to watch any of the games that were streamed on Diamond One, just go back in the feed. You will find them there. Be sure to check out that final again. It had everything. For the Hutt Valley Softball Association and the rest of the O4 commentary crew, we had Chanel Masters on the video switcher, Stacey Taylor at ground announcing, my man Jason Gerbes, aka Chopper, and doing the play-by-play. I've been Damien Collins. Thank you for joining us. We're going to end this feed, and we'll be back with the prize giving right after this.